A very pleasant morning to all my dear children. Welcome back to English Online class of Sri Govilam Public School, Guruvayur. I hope you all are doing great and staying safe at home, children. Yes? Okay. Then let's start our today's session. We are discussing lesson 8, prepositions from our Excellence in English grammar text. In the last class, we already discussed what is a preposition. Still, let's revise what we have already gone through. Okay, so let's look at the examples given in our text. Look at the first one. The first one is, the porcupine is in the cage. The second one, the bus is on the road. And the third one, it is, the comics are under the Max book. And the last one, the packets are on the table. See, children, I have stressed some words in these sentences, isn't it? So, which are those words? They are in, on, and under. Now, these words have some function in these sentences. What are they actually doing in these sentences? Let's see. Here, on, it brings a relationship or it shows a relationship between the two words, the packets and the table. And both the packets and the table are nouns. So, it shows a relationship between the word packet and the table. So, what is the function of on? It tells us how they are related. It tells us how these two words are related. For example, if I say the packets, the table. Did you get any meaning? No. And can you find any relation between these two words? No. The packets and the table, they stand separate. No relationship is there between these two words, isn't it? So the word on, it shows a relationship between these two words. So look at the other examples. Let's look at the first one. The porcupine is in the cage. Here, the word in, it brings a relationship between the words porcupine and cage. Okay? It shows us the relationship. Both are related. And in the second one, the bus is on the road. Again, the word on, it brings a relationship between bus and road. The third one, the comics are under the Max book. Here also, the word under, it brings a relationship between the words comics and Max book. Okay? So, what is the function of prepositions, children? The prepositions is placed before nouns and it shows a relationship between noun or pronoun in a sentence to another words in a sentence. I hope you understood what is a preposition. So, prepositions are the words, or preposition is a word that is used before nouns and it shows a relationship between the noun or pronoun in a sentence to another words in a sentence. The common prepositions are in, on, at, by, from, of, to, towards, above, below, up, down, over, behind, beneath, beside, across, around, round. All these are prepositions and there are many more prepositions, children. So now let's see the three types of prepositions. These prepositions are categorized into three types according to their functions in a sentence. Okay, so let's see the three types of preposition. Let's see the first one, preposition of place. The common prepositions of place are on, in, at, by, behind. All these are common prepositions of place. These prepositions, it denotes place, where something happened or where something is kept. For example, he hung the picture on the wall. So if something is attached to the wall, I can say he hung the picture on the wall. Or look at the picture on the wall. I can say the child sat on the table. So as the table, it is a surface level. There is no closure. It is an open space, isn't it? The topmost part of a thing, right? And there is no closure, so I can use on. The book is kept on the table, or the child sat on the table. So in order to denote such places like the surface level of something, we can use on. Okay? And the next one, in. We can use in to show enclosed area. Enclosed area means a closed area. For example, my grandfather sits in the armchair. Armchair, it has a little bit of closing because it has two supports on each sides of the chair. We can rest our arms on that support. So as it has a closure, we can say that grandfather is sitting in the chair. And the example, I was sitting in my car. As car is an enclosed area, it's a closed space, right? So I can use in. I'm inside something, so I can use in. The pencil is in the box. as we can close the box, as it is an enclosed space, we can use in. Okay, so in shows the place where the pencil is kept or where my grandfather is sitting. The next preposition is at. At shows the exact point or the exact place. It shows the particular place. For example, I met him at the station. So where did I meet him? I am referring to a particular place, to an exact point of place. What is that place? It is at the station. He stood at the gate. So I am referring to the place. Which place, children? The gate. So I am referring to the particular place, and that is the gate. So if we want to refer to a particular place, we can use at. The next preposition is by. By is also a preposition of place. For example, we can say the telephone is by the window. Why did I use by here? To refer to the place. Where is the telephone? It is near the window. Behind. Behind means at the back of. So I hung the coat behind the door. I hung the coat behind the, or at the back of the door. So these are the common prepositions of place. Let's see prepositions of time. Prepositions of time are the same words as prepositions of place. However, they are used in a different way, in a different meaning. Okay. So the common prepositions of time are at, on, in. All these are common prepositions as we used in preposition of place. Let's see the first one, at. At is used to denote talk times, or it is also used to denote festivals or holidays. For example, the meeting ended at 7 o'clock. Here I want to refer to the clock time, so I used at, and it shows the time, isn't it? When the meeting got over. Then the next one, to denote holidays or festivals, also we can use at. We have a week's holiday at Christmas. So again, it denotes the time. When do we have holidays? During Christmas. It shows time. Now let's see the usage of in. It can be used to denote a period of time, like the parts of a day. We set out our journey in the morning, in the afternoon, in the evenings. So in order to refer these parts of the day, we can use in. Okay, and it shows time. When did we start our journey? In the morning. Okay, so in order to denote time, we can use in. In is also used before seasons, before months, and before year. For example, I visited Agra in July. So in is used before months, in July. The next one, India attained independence in August 1947. So again, I have used in before the month. In winter, day is short and night is long. So I have used in before the season. So in can be used before the parts of the day, like morning, afternoon, and evening. And it can also be used before seasons, months, and year. Another example, in evenings, I like to relax. So these are the common usages of in. Now let's see the usage of on. On is also used as preposition of time. The common usage of on is, it is used before days and it is used before dates. Okay. For example, my birthday is on 5th December. So I have used on before the date. Which is the date? 5th. So I can also use on before the days also. The meeting will be held on Monday, or the function will be held on Thursday. So I can use on before the days and also before the dates. Okay, so this is the common usages of on, in, and at. Now let's see the prepositions of direction. The common prepositions of directions are to, into, onto, through, toward. All these are common prepositions of direction. And these prepositions, it denotes the movement from one place to another. For example, the bullet went through his head, but he survived. So here we are showing the movement of that bullet. It went through his head, but he survived. Survived means still he is alive. The next example, we watched the bus disappear into the tunnel. So here the bus is moving from one place to another. It went inside the tunnel. Okay. So in order to show the movement from one place to another, we can use these common prepositions of direction. So children, there are many more prepositions of place, prepositions of time, and prepositions of direction. And they also have different usages. We'll see all those in our higher classes. So let's study only these basic usages of these common prepositions. Okay. Now let's see the basic usages of into, among, and between. Into is used in order to refer to something inside something. For example, come into the house. If I say someone to come into the house, I mean I'm asking them or I'm requesting them to come or get inside the house. The usage of among and between. Between is used to refer to two things, and among is used to refer to more than two things. When something is surrounded by, in order to refer to two things which are clearly separated, we can use between. For example, our holiday house is between the mountains and the sea. Mountains is on one side and the sea is on the other side. So they both are clearly separated. So in between that mountains and the sea is our holiday house. Okay, the next one, among. Among means it is a part of or surrounded by. For example, the ancient fountain is hidden among the trees. Among the trees means it is surrounded by trees. Ancient fountain, ancient means old. A old fountain was found among the trees. Among the trees means it was found surrounded by the trees. Another example, she wanted to be among friends. Among friends means she wanted to be in the company of friends, in the circle of many friends. She wanted to be surrounded by many friends. If I say he stood between his father and mother, so I am referring to two persons and they are clearly separated. Okay, he is standing in between them. So children, try to do the textual exercises. I have given you a model of how to do all the textual exercises. So copy down, children. So I hope you understood today's topic clearly. That's all for today. Let's wind up the session. See you in the next class.